Is the Brightline West a rail revolution or a waste of time? This question is on the minds of many as we look to the future of rail travel in the US. Rail travel in the United States is at a crossroads. On one side, we have the current state of affairs, a system that, while functional, often falls behind its global counterparts when it comes to speed and connectivity. On the other side, we have the proposed Brightline West, a high-speed rail project that aims to revolutionize train travel by connecting Las Vegas and Southern California. This ambitious project, however, is not without controversy. Critics argue that the investment needed for such a venture could be better used elsewhere, while proponents see it as a necessary step towards a more efficient and sustainable future. Meanwhile, the Biden administration's infrastructure plan has added a new dimension to this debate. With a proposed budget of $80 billion for rail upgrades, the potential for sweeping changes in the landscape of American rail travel is greater than ever. However, the allocation of these funds is a contentious issue. A significant portion of this budget could potentially be used for high-speed rail projects like the Brightline West and California's bullet train. Yet the plan has been criticized for its lack of clarity regarding how states will spend the rail money and its economic viability. Amid these controversies and uncertainties, the future of rail travel in the US is somewhat murky. But one thing is clear: the decisions we make now will shape the face of American transportation for generations to come. Despite the criticism, projects like the Brightline West have the potential to redefine what we think of when we think of train travel. By providing faster, safer, and greener options, these high-speed rail networks could usher in a new era of transportation in the US. With these facts in mind, it seems that the Brightline West could be a game changer, but the debate is still ongoing. Now let's dive deeper into the proposed rail projects and how they stack up against each other. Turning the spotlight first on the Vegas bullet train, officially known as Brightline West, this high-speed rail project is nothing short of ambitious. Planned to connect Las Vegas and Southern California, this train is set to revolutionize travel between these two major hubs. The proposed rail system is expected to dramatically reduce travel times, making it a tantalizing option for commuters and tourists alike. However, like any major infrastructure project, it's not without its challenges. The project's high cost and the potential environmental impact are valid concerns raised by critics. On the other hand, we have the California High-Speed Rail Project. This ambitious plan aims to connect the mega regions of the state, from San Francisco to Los Angeles, and eventually extend to Sacramento and San Diego. The project promises to transform travel within California, reducing lengthy car and air travel times. However, questions about the project's feasibility, cost overruns, and delays have cast shadows over this ambitious vision. Comparing these two projects, they both champion the idea of fast, efficient, and sustainable travel. They promise to reduce reliance on car and air travel, which could have significant environmental benefits. However, the devil, as they say, is in the details. The high-speed rail projects carry hefty price tags, and there are valid concerns about their economic viability. Furthermore, the projects will need to navigate a complex landscape of regulatory, environmental, and community concerns. Both projects also face competition from existing transportation modes. The Vegas bullet train will be competing with airlines and the good old American road trip tradition. The California high-speed rail, on the other hand, faces stiff competition from well-established flight routes and the convenience of car travel. Nevertheless, the potential benefits of these projects are hard to ignore. If successful, they could usher in a new era of rail travel in the United States, offering a greener and more efficient alternative to air and car travel. However, the road to realization is long, and these projects will undoubtedly face many more challenges along the way. On a final note, it's worth mentioning the role of the Biden administration in these projects. The administration has pledged $3 billion each to the Vegas bullet train and the California high-speed rail project. This substantial financial backing reflects the administration's commitment to revitalizing America's rail infrastructure, but skeptics question whether this will be money well spent. As we can see, each project brings its own set of potential benefits and drawbacks, and it's clear that the future of rail travel in the US will be shaped by these ambitious plans. So, what could these proposed projects mean for the future of rail travel in the US? Well, let's dive right in and explore the potential impacts of these rail projects. With a focus on the Brightline West, the Vegas bullet train, and the California high-speed rail, we're talking about a potential revolution in how we travel. Imagine this: reduced travel times, more connectivity, and a fresh, modern approach to rail travel. Picture yourself zipping from Las Vegas to Southern California in just a few hours, all while sitting back and enjoying the ride. This could be a reality with the Vegas bullet train. Then there's the environmental impact to consider. Rail travel is a much greener alternative to air or car travel. With climate change becoming an increasingly pressing issue, the shift towards more sustainable modes of transportation could be a game changer. And let's not forget about the potential job creation from these projects, a boost to local economies right when it's needed the most. But as with all grand plans, there are potential drawbacks to consider. The cost of these projects is a major factor. Billions of dollars are being pledged, and there's always the risk of costs spiraling out of control. Are these projects feasible, or are they too ambitious? And then there's the question of demand. Will these high-speed rails attract enough riders to justify their construction and operation? After all, these trains need to be more than just fast and modern. They need to be practical and affordable for the average traveler. There's also the issue of sharing tracks with freight railroads. This has been a cause of delays in the past and could potentially slow down these high-speed trains. Will this be addressed in the new plans, or will it remain a hurdle? Despite these challenges, there's a sense of optimism. These projects represent a bold vision for the future. They're about more than just trains. They're about reimagining how we travel and connect with each other. While these projects hold great promise for the future of rail travel in the US, it remains to be seen whether they can deliver on these promises. Let's now summarize the main points we've discussed in this video. We began by looking at the future of rail travel in the US, particularly in the context of President Biden's American Jobs Plan. This proposal, which has been met with both enthusiasm and skepticism, includes an $80 billion allocation to upgrade the nation's rail system, with a focus on incremental improvements, repairs, and enhancements to the existing network. We then delved into the specifics of some proposed rail projects, notably the Brightline West and the California High-Speed Rail. These initiatives, which have been promised $3 billion each from the Biden administration, aim to revolutionize rail travel by providing faster, safer, and greener options. However, critics argue that these plans lack ambition, failing to prioritize high-speed rail and potentially wasting valuable resources. We also touched on the potential impact of these projects. The Biden administration's plan is expected to improve train service and infrastructure, particularly in the Northeast Corridor and certain regions on the West Coast. However, concerns have been raised about the economic viability of new rail projects to less populated areas, as well as the slower trip times compared to car travel. Lastly, we discussed the controversy surrounding the Brightline West. This project, which proposes to connect Las Vegas and Southern California with high-speed rail, has been hailed as a potential game-changer for rail travel in the region. However, detractors argue that it's a waste of time and resources, citing challenges in attracting new riders and building support for world-class rail in the US. In conclusion, the future of rail travel in the US is poised for potentially revolutionary changes. But whether these changes will be beneficial or detrimental is still up for debate. Only time will tell. As we wrap up this discussion, we must remember that the future of rail travel in the US is in our hands. It's not just about the train enthusiasts or the daily commuters, but about every citizen whose life can be impacted by these developments. It's about the potential for a greener, more efficient, and connected nation. The proposed projects, such as Brightline West and the California High-Speed Rail, have the potential to revolutionize travel, bringing us closer together and reducing our carbon footprint. But they also come with their own set of challenges. The financial feasibility, the infrastructure requirements, and the time it will take to see these projects come to fruition are all factors we need to consider. This is why it's crucial for all of us to stay informed and engaged in the discussions around the future of rail travel. It's about understanding the potential benefits these projects can bring, but also being aware of their drawbacks. It's about asking the right questions and demanding transparency and accountability from those in charge. Thank you for joining us in this discussion. Remember, the future of rail travel in the US depends on us. Stay informed, stay engaged, and let's shape the future together.